horse hex. I was on my way to Nashville, and then I realized that I left propaganda at Steak and Shake. And I turned my car around immediately. For those of you that don't know, propaganda is the little orange dinosaur that I carry around with me. And I am not crazy. But I will change my plans. I mean, I'm still going to Nashville. But I am greatly inconveniencing myself, also that I can retrieve him.
Because he's special to me.
And I don't want him to be alone. I've been listening to this Allman Brothers concert, and I read this interview recently with Annie Clark, aka St. Vincent, who is probably the best artist of our time. And she was saying that there are scientific studies that prove that being at a live concert increases your empathy. And that made so much sense out of my existence. Because, I kid you not, every single time that I listen to any live performance, and the end of the concert, every time, it doesn't matter how many times I've listened to the concert, I will just start crying. And the same is true for, like, comedy shows. I thought it was because of the applause. I thought that there was something about the applause that was triggering me. But that's not the case because, you know, at every live show, people are gonna clap after every single song. But upon reading this interview with Annie, I realized the reason why I get so emotional. Because I feel like I'm at the concert, or I feel like I'm at the comedy gig, or whatever it is, you know? And that's so powerful, especially when you have a concert that's what, like 30, 40, 50 years old, or like a comedy show from the 70s or 80s, and you feel like you were there. But it is a really, really powerful experience, you know? Because every concert that I've been to, I do feel really connected to all those people. Even though I really hate people, and even more than people, I hate crowds of people. But I just thought that was a pretty cool thing. I'm glad it's not because of narcissism, because that's what I was worried about. But you know, it's kind of dumb to be worried that I'm something bad, you know? Because a bad person wouldn't be concerned, you know? A bad person wouldn't be like, oh no, I'm a bad person. I should work on that, you know? A bad person would be like, I deserve to be a bad person, or fuck them. It doesn't matter, you know? Not to say that people can't be overzealous in their empathy and that can be kind of sickening too, you know? If you're ever bragging about it, it's probably not true, you know? Because you can't brag about humility. And empathy is definitely not something to brag about because people don't understand it, you know? They really don't. People will make fun of you if you have empathy. Now, I understand that we shouldn't have so much empathy that we let people off the hook. Because people should be held accountable for their actions. And I think I've told you about this guy that I used to work with, who I prayed for a lot. But he's one of those people that obviously didn't receive any of those prayers because he's facing 2 felony charges. And apparently the cop showed up at his house yesterday and confiscated his computer where he's been doing all these drug deals. He was caught selling fentanyl in a school zone, which is a Schedule 2 drug. He's one of these people that's been trying to overdose multiple times. He's just a piece of shit, okay? He's a piece of shit, and he doesn't care about his life. And he's hurt a lot of people because of that, you know? I feel really bad for his parents. But I was just thinking about, you know, 12-step programs. You know, I bitch about 12-step programs all the time. The main reason that I have an issue with 12-step crap is because it's so easy to pretend that you're doing work on yourself when really you're just there to get pussy or you're just there to find more drugs, you know? Because, like, when I wasn't ready to get sober, it actually gave me tips on how to get away with drinking, you know? Like this one time I was going through really bad alcohol withdrawals, and I remembered something that somebody had said in an AA meeting about how they were drinking vanilla extract, and I kid you not, I went into my mother's little cabinet and I drank all of those extracts back to back. Threw up in the sink, because that was pretty disgusting. But I stopped shaking. So I learned that from AA meetings. Because I'm a very receptive person. But yeah, a lot of people that go to 12-step programs aren't there to actually do any real work on themselves. They're there to lie to themselves, essentially. And then they can gaslight their friends and their family, as well as the entire judicial system. And of course, the judicial system is fine with this because the judicial system's nothing but a fucking joke. But I met some pretty cool people in there that were like legit. And they really knew the program and they were actually in it to help themselves and help other people. But sadly, like I've mentioned before, most people don't do anything for the right reason, you know? But, I feel sorry for my friend, but at the same time I don't. I mean, he wasn't ever really my friend. He was my coworker. But, you know, some people just never get it because they don't care about themselves. And if they don't care about themselves, how could they care about anybody else? But I bet you they're gonna fuck him up in prison.